I want to show you a few settings that you can apply to InDesign to speed up your workflow. First off, when I create a new document, you'll notice that the measurement for this document and any new document is going to be set to picas. Let's change this up so that every time we create a new document, it's already set to the measurement that I'm used to. I'm going to click Close and go to my InDesign menu and go to Preferences. If you're on a Windows machine, just go to Edit and go to Preferences, and we'll go to our Units and Increments tab. You'll see here that my measurement is set to picas. Let's switch this up and set it to something that we're more familiar with. I'm going to go to my drop-down menu here and select Points. I recommend Points because it's easier to control things incrementally when adjusting values. I'll click OK. Let's create a new document. And you'll see here that the unit of measurement is already set to points. If you don't know the conversion for points to inches, that's okay. You just go in here and type in your value, maybe 4 inches by 9 inches, and you can see it'll automatically convert that inch value into points. Let's click Create, and there's my document. Another quick preference we can do deals with our images that we place into this document. I'll create a frame, and I'll go to my File menu and place a document. When I place a graphic into InDesign, most of the time our settings are set to typical display. That means that your image will display at a fast render so that you can work with your document a lot quicker. A lot of our machines can handle this now, and so what we could do here per document and per frame is we can right click and go to our display performance and set this to high quality display. Again, I have to do this though for every frame in every new document. If we change this in our preferences, we can omit that and work a lot faster. I'm going to close out this document and I'll go back to my preferences. Again, InDesign, or if you're on a Windows machine, go to Edit and go to Preferences, and this time we'll go to our display performance. Here you'll notice that the default view for our display performance is set to typical. I'm going to switch this up to high quality, and so now when we place a graphic, it'll showcase that image at a high quality display. I'll click OK, and there you go. Another way to speed up your workflow is to define your colors and your font before you create a new document. This will become the default settings for InDesign, so when you create a new document, you don't have to go ahead and set those up every single time. To do this, we'll go to our Window menu, and we'll first start off with our colors. So I'll open up the Swatches panel, and you'll notice here that we have our basic default colors. If we add colors now, again, those will be our defaults. So I'm going to go to my Swatches menu here, and I'm going to add a new color swatch, and we'll type in the value that we want to use. We're going to go ahead and type in 540.92, and this will give us this orange color for Lumenbright. I'll click OK, and you'll see here that that color has been added to my Swatches panel. Now I can add all the colors that I need to use to follow my branding guides, and those will be available every time I create a new document. Another thing that we can set is the font that we have to use within our documents. Again, if you set this before anything's open, that'll be your default font every time you create a new document. To do this, let's go to your Window menu, and I'll go to my Styles, and this time I'll open up my Paragraph Styles. Every time you create a new document, you're going to get a basic paragraph style. If we adjust this, again, this will be the default. So if I open up Basic Paragraph and go to my Basic Character Formats tab, you'll notice here that it's set to Minion Pro. This is the default for InDesign. I can open this up and I can select whatever font that I need to use to follow my branding guidelines. I'm just going to go ahead and choose Acumen Pro and click OK. So now that I have these set, every time I create a new document, those will be my defaults. Let's check it out. I'll go to File, New, and create a new document. I'll choose one of these presets. I'll select Letter and click Create. And now when I create a text frame or a shape, I'll have those colors ready to go. So if I grab my shape tool and draw a rectangle, you'll notice here that I have that option available in the fill properties and stroke properties of my shape. If I grab my type tool and draw out a frame, again, you'll notice that the default font already is applied to my frame, Acumen Pro. So again, if you apply all the styles and all the colors that you need for your document, again, follow your branding guidelines, you will not have to set this up every time you create a new document.